Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. If there's one thing I learned from the backwards bicycle experiment, it's that knowledge is not understanding. So a couple years ago when I made the YouTube series about helicopter physics, I gained the knowledge of how they work, but not really the understanding. So today on Smarter Every Day, I'm gonna try to hover a helicopter. I've heard it's the hardest thing you can do, specifically the Robinson 22, because it's a pure helicopter. There's no augmentation. So today on Smarter Every Day, we're gonna learn what goes into doing that and what her brain is doing. It's really quite incredible. Let's go get smarter every day.
I'm gonna be straight up with you. I'm convinced that helicopter instructor pilots are either complete idiots or incredibly brave. I mean, think about it. They get into a helicopter with someone they've never met and give them the controls.
This is my first rotary
crash course.
No, I don't want to take a crash course.
Notice that the controls are actually connected together, which means if I do something stupid, Brandon has to wrestle the controls out of my hand or just trust that I'm going to let go. That's crazy. Anyway, watch how bad I fly every single time he gives me the controls, and you can easily tell when he takes back over.
Almost got it. There you go. Pedal to your heading. Crap. So I'm going to try that. We're going to taxi down.
Yep. So you have the control.
I have the control. Okay, you got it.
All right, so you have the cyclic. All right, just try to hold us in this spot.
All right,
let's get us back over that left.
Good grief, man. All right, you're going to have to take over. You got it?
Yep, I got it. Go forward.
My bad. Jeez. Whoop, let's don't hit the sign, how you say.
Mr. Romeo is the tip of Honeymoon.
Yeah, you have the craziest job in the world.
It has its ups and its downs.
That's an awful joke. So there's a moment when it clicks?
Yeah.
How long does it normally take?
6 to 8 hours.
How long is it gonna take me?
6 to 8 months.
My next instructor was Tommy. We went out in the R-44 because the R-22 was down for maintenance. I started to watch how they teach. I noticed that if I was doing something stupid, their hands would get closer to the controls. And then when I was doing something easy, like flying straight and level, then they get more relaxed. Anyway, instructors call this part, when we're learning how to hover, the rodeo. One of the best things that Tommy did for me was teach me how to chill out. The thing I was doing was called a pilot-induced oscillation. I was basically freaking out and over-controlling, which made the whole aircraft wobble. Once I chilled, I was able to stabilize. Tommy got this to click in my brain by first teaching me how delicately to operate the controls, and then showing me how two controls interact with each other.
If you move the control, you've moved too much.
If you move the control.
You see what I'm saying, though?
Yeah,
it's that whole thought process of it all. All right, using only left pedal and only left pedal again, point me at that tree over there.
It's like not even a thought.
Right, there you go. So something just clicked in your brain, I can tell.
Okay. Okay, I have collective, I have pedals. I'm going to try to point at the stop sign. I'm going to raise, and I'm going to keep pointing at the stop sign.
Oh yeah, look, something else just clicked.
So why do you have to move multiple controls to do one simple maneuver? Turns out, this is the secret of hovering a helicopter.
Okay, you've seen Rubik's Cube solvers, right? These guys that like have it stored somewhere in their brainstem and they can just look at it and just instantly understand what they need to do, right? To solve the thing. Well, that's exactly what helicopter pilots are doing, because if you think about it, every time you change something on a Rubik's Cube, multiple inputs are changing all over the thing. It's a whole system. That's the way helicopters work. You have to come up with the most efficient and effective solution instantly to arrive at that perfect solution right off the bat. That's something that you just have to get in muscle memory somehow. Okay, there are three main controls for a helicopter. The first one is what we call collective. Collective is your power that you're applying to the rotor system. Basically, the swash plate moves together and it rotates those rotor blades so that they're taking more or less of a bite out of the air. Now, if you think about that, when you do that, it applies more torque or less torque to the body of the helicopter, right? So you have to counteract that with the pedals. When she moves the pedals back and forth, that, of course, gives you more or less counter torque on the body of the whole aircraft. Another thing you have to think about is that tail rotor is blowing air, so it's pushing the whole helicopter to the side, right? So the way you counteract that is what? Cyclic. Cyclic is similar to collective in that it moves the rotors in the swash plate, only it does it independently. You can see that it's changing the swash plate so that the rotors are moving independently of each other. What she has to do is she has to take all three of these inputs, make them work together. Now imagine that happening several times a second and you have kind of an idea of what's going on in Michelle's brain, right? No?
This takes way more brain power.
All right, the next flight is with Michelle, who happens to be really sassy. When we got into the R-22, she says, just so you know, I'm a little bit more hands-off, which basically meant if I got into a pilot-induced oscillation, she was gonna make me recover.
Am I doing this or are you doing this? Okay, thank you.
I kind of didn't believe her, though, until she let me take off this horribly.
Golly.
That's one way to do it.
You're awful. So you are hands off.
And we're off.
She basically forced me to straighten up by taking away my safety net, but I got better really fast.
Well,
I thought you said you sucked at this.
I do suck at this.
Eh? Look into me. All right, you have the controls.
Okay, so first I'm going to take off. That's the first thing you have to do. I'm teaching you how to do this now, right?
So. I appreciate that. Perfect, there you go.
All right, so there we are. We're hovering.
We are hovering.
Poorly, but we're hovering.
It's happening.
I'm going to try to land over there and act like I know what I'm doing, even though I don't.
I believe in you.
Okay, so here we go. I'm looking outside, looking outside, looking outside, looking outside. I'm starting to commit, starting to commit, starting to commit, and we're down.
Boom. I appreciate you teaching me that.
Okay, I'm gonna hold this. Boom.
Very nicely done.
Okay, so Brandon was crazy enough to start with me, and I decided to end with him so I could assess my progress. By this point, I could take off, navigate to wherever he wanted me, shoot an approach, and even land. But remember, my goal was to be able to hover and do it well. Brandon had a test for that.
There is a stick over here. I want to see if you could land on it. Oh, you want me to land with the skids on that stick? Am I on it? Yeah, you are. I can't even. You're on it. Impressive.
I want to see you put it down on that same spot.
Okay, is this like the test? If I can do this, then I...
You go solo, right?
Dude, we're touching the stick.
Final for 3-4.
Boom, touching the stick. I'm very excited. That's a big deal to me.
Yeah, that's actually really good. It just helps teach you precision.
So there you go. Hovering a helicopter is hilariously hard. I thought it was up for down, left and right. Oh no. It's a complex coupled control system and you have to rewire your brain to make it happen. It's pretty awesome. Anyway, thank you to the cities of St. Petersburg and Clearwater, Florida. They invited me down and sponsored this video to let me do this. It was amazing. I got to hover a helicopter while my kids were playing on the beach below. That's amazing. Also, there's plenty of other stuff you can do. They didn't tell me how to promote them, so I'm just gonna tell you what we did. We went to the Chihuly Museum, which is one of the most famous glass artists in the world. There's a museum down there. Also, the Salvador Dali Museum. You know the guy, melting clocks, burning giraffes. There's a huge museum of nothing but awesome art. Also, there's an M.C. Escher traveling exhibit when we were there. We got to meet Winter the Dolphin. You've heard of this dolphin, the dolphin that's missing its tail and they're working with it. We had a blast. If you are looking for a place to take a vacation, please consider the St. Pete, Clearwater, Florida area. It's a great place just to go chill on the beach. If you get a chance, visit St. Pete, Clearwater. Please consider it. I'll leave a link in the video description. Thank you for sponsoring this. I appreciate that. Anyway, I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one.
So you don't think hovering is like that? You have to, well, you're already messing it up. I can tell you that right now.
Are you going to be a fixed wing instructor?
No, I have no desire to be a fixed wing instructor.
Why is that?
I don't like flying airplanes. Think about it. Can you do this right here in an airplane?
No.
All right then.
We're here with Winter, the dolphin at Clearwater Marine Aquarium and her trainers. And your names are?
Cammy.
And Julie. All right. And this is Winter's prosthetic tail. So this is where I practice some helicopter maneuvers, and this is the Dali Museum.
But you can do that with a helicopter quickly.
Yeah.